Today, we will discuss bones. We will talk about human bones that show a glow-in-the-dark effect on the glow of cremated remains. I hope to convince you that ambient heating of a composite material with organic and inorganic components, that it may lead to a room temperature phosphorescent material with organic triplet state emitters. And I mean heating to about 600 degrees for a few minutes. Imagine you are at a murder scene that has been set ablaze. Burned bones will be present in the fire debris. It is our legal and moral duty to find these bones, and their emissive properties may help. It may seem far-fetched to use their luminescence to find these bones and learn about their temperature history, but it is getting a lot of attention also in archaeology. Some people even try to combine it with drones. A couple of years ago, Maurice Alders, professor at the Amsterdam University Medical Center, he asked me, how can it be that bones that have been heated, that they show a glow-in-the-dark effect? Tristan encounters this phenomenon in his PhD research. Mark Ronald and Michiel, they helped us with laser spectroscopy. This work is mainly done by Emma Schut, a master student of forensic science, and she studied the long-lived green emission of human bones. And we published this work in 2024. Here in the middle, we see that heating a bone to 400 degrees, that it produces a lot of black graphitic material. But upon further heating, this black color is lost. But first, what is bone? Bone contains about 30% collagen, a coiled up polypeptide mainly containing glycine, proline, and hydroxyproline. And this forms fibrils that are intercalated with very small inorganic crystals of calcium phosphate. These fibrils make up a so-called plywood pattern. This plywood pattern makes up the macroscopic bone, and it is a little bit like a brick and mortar structure. And it's not just phosphate, it also contains some carbonate and hydroxide in what we call bone apatite. So here we see some of these bone samples that have been heated, and most of these bones, they show emission, but only the ones that have been heated to about 600 degrees, they show a very long-lived emission. So here we see the bone pieces under daylight. In the middle, we see them under UV lamp. And here the excitation is taken away. So we just see the long component. So you can wonder, what is the emitter? What is the species that emits this light? And what kind of decay process are we looking at? Do any hypotheses come to mind? Next to these triplet states that I already mentioned, there's another option. Think about radiative charge recombination. Like in silver halide photography, photo-induced charges can be trapped by defects. When these charges detrap, they can give emission. Radiative charge recombination can also give a very long-lived emission. And this also occurs in a lot of commercial glow-in-the-dark materials. And it also happens in perovskites. But the detrapping of these charges, it's thermally activated. So if you cool the system, you can distinguish the process. The temperature dependence of the luminescence of these bones indicates that triplet states are responsible for the emission. The emission becomes stronger if we cool down, but we do have some hysteresis. So cooling gives a slightly different behavior than heating back to room temperature. And this probably has to do with a large density of states and a heterogeneous distribution of the emitters. Therefore, we believe we have a carbon-based material a decomposition product of the graphite precursor. And this material we like to call a carbon quantum dot. And it is there in various sizes with their own emission. Just part of this population gives this long-lived green emission. Note that we have a singlet ground state. There has to be also a singlet excited state. But we see the emission from the triplet excited state with the two spins parallel. Convocal laser scanning microscopy, it shows a very heterogeneous distribution of emitters. These red emitters here on the right, they have a different distribution and a different occurrence if you compare them to the green emitters here on the left. In the middle, we see an overlay. And we can visualize the plywood pattern if we use a dye that absorbs onto the fibers of the bone. But we can actually also see these types of fiber structures if we don't use a dye. And here we compare it to electron microscopy from another source. Also, the steady state excitation emission matrix, it shows a very heterogeneous distribution of emitters. We have red emitters, but we also have green emitters. But how can it be that these triplet states are not quenched by oxygen? Oxygen is a triplet in the ground state. I told you about this before at a different occasion. Oxygen can interact with excited state triplets by what we call triplet-triplet annihilation. Yes, we are not only talking about bones, but also about things that annihilate. It has been described that heating of bone apatite, that it results in restructuring of the inorganic matrix. It restructures around the organic fragments that thereby become protected. As the graphitic phase decomposes, small graphite-like parts, they remain and they are protected by the inorganic matrix, protected from oxygen and further oxidation. The carbon quantum dot material, it contains multiple fused benzene rings, probably three or more, and it can be present as a monomer, a dimer, or even a trimer. So we like to present it like this. Also, the time-resolved emission, it indicates a very heterogeneous system. So here we see three timescales obtained with single photon counting, with our optical multi-channel analyzer, and as well as time traces from the video recordings. And all these time traces, they show a tri-exponential behavior. So it seems that ambient heating of a mixture of collagen and calcium phosphate, that it leads to a room temperature phosphorescent material with organic triplet state emitters. I was flabbergasted when I found this paper that essentially shows the same, but they used rice and silica to get these triplet emitters that they call carbon dots. Very similar things have been observed in the material science fields focused on phosphorescent materials for lighting. But now, propionic acid is the precursor of the organic component, and yttrium aluminium borate is the matrix. Atul, who also works in Science Park, he published four papers about this. So clearly, ambient heating of a composite material with organic and inorganic components leads to a room temperature phosphorescent material with organic triplet state emitters. Last but not least, room temperature phosphorescent materials are getting a lot of attention. Here we see two recent review papers. These materials can, for instance, be used in safety features in banknotes. Even peanut butter shows a glow-in-the-dark effect, but that is probably due to riboflavin, also called vitamin B2. Thank you for your attention.